It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
Hey guys, Tyler here. So, I found a video talking about this term called Weiss again, and I figure I give my two cents about this term because it's just really, really pathetic.
En México les decimos fresas o whitexicans. En Guatemala, caqueros o guatemalans. En Brasil, mauriciños. En Bolivia, jailones. En Venezuela, sifirinos. En Perú, fichos o pitucos. Cada país tiene su manera de llamarle a la gente con dinero privilegiada, casi siempre de tez blanca.
What is so interesting about this video is that it does not talk about the history of the word whitexican, because the person behind the word has some very grave issues. The word whitexican started around 2018 by this account called Costa de Whitexicans. And basically this account has a lot of stuff they consider to be white for Mexicans. For example, the account considers being pro-life as a white thing. The account considers having a golden retriever as a white thing. And the account considers being a Trump supporter a white thing. What is so strange about these terms is that they could apply for almost everybody. For example, almost all people want a dog. Almost all people have different backgrounds for Donald Trump. All people with different backgrounds also support the pro-life movement. And so, I don't think that supporting a dog, supporting like the pro-life movement, supporting Donald Trump is really a white thing. Also, it's very racist to assume that someone has it better than you because of your own personal race, because there are white people who are poor, there are white people who are middle class, there are white people who are rich, that is true. However, you cannot assume the position of a person exclusively by their skin color.
Y algunas de ellas se ofenden cuando les llaman así, incluso lo consideran un acto de racismo. ¿Son estereotipos? Sí. Prejuicios, claro, pero racismo definitivamente no. El racismo a la inversa o de abajo hacia arriba no existe, es un mito.
It's true that reverse racism doesn't exist. However, even though reverse racism does not exist, we can still have examples of people being racist towards other people for the fact of being a different color. So, it's not just systemic racism. Racism can also happen on an individual base. However, I find it so strange that we're talking about racism because this video is from Qatar that is known for various slaves for their freaking games. And so I don't think they're in a position to talk about racism with us.
Tener preconceptos raciales hacia una persona blanca o de cualquier otra etnia nunca va a ser algo bueno.
If that was the case, that is very dangerous to talk about one group of people in a particular way, why are you talking about these whitexicans?
Cuando escuchamos la palabra racista, casi siempre nos viene a la mente esta imagen.
Get down on your knees.
O esta otra.
You know what? In America, we speak English.
Esos son ejemplos de racismo individual.
I don't think the example with the woman saying speak English is necessarily a racist thing. Because to me, if you want to move to a country where the predominant language is spoken, and a person chooses not to, you know, respect the predominant language of the land, then I'm sorry, you might, you know, want to, you know, adopt to the culture and the customs that we have in the United States. So, I don't think wanting the immigrants to come and speak English is really a racist thing in the slightest.
Pero esto es solo un engrane del racismo sistémico estructural. Como lo indica su nombre, este racismo está presente en las instituciones que nos rigen, por lo que las creencias o actitudes individuales importan muy poco o nada.
I find it so strange that we're talking about systemic racism in Mexico when the freaking president is AMLO right now, and he's actually a mestizo. Like, most Mexicans are mestizos. And so, basically, it's so strange. Like, if there's systemic racism, what's preventing the people from becoming in high positions of power?
Pero solo es cuestión de echarse un clavado a la historia de tu país. La colonización resultó en la esclavitud de personas indígenas y aquellas secuestradas y traídas del continente africano. Los pueblos originarios que no fueron esclavizados fueron despojados o desplazados. Sí, hubo mestizaje, pero no fue un proceso ni voluntario ni de conciliación. Y si era resultado de alguna de estas mezclas, tus derechos dependían de qué tanta sangre europea tenías en las venas.
I find it so strange that we always talk about slavery with white people and the Europeans in the Americas, because prior to the conquer of like the Americas, there were also various slaves from different parts of the world, and of course other people wanted to conquer other people. And so this idea that somehow the white man is always guilty of slavery is a myth, because every single time people bring up slavery, they always want to put the fault on white people. But it's not true. That is not true in the freaking slightest. I don't think that we should always make people feel bad about past events, because the person of that person is not the same person as before. There are individuals that can make their own personal judgment, their own choices. So why are we blaming white people for everything that's bad in the world? If we do the exact same thing with other groups of people, there'll be riots. But it's perfectly fine to be racist against white people because it's socially acceptable. This is why this term is very racist. Many people want to use this term to say, oh, white conqueror, oh, you have it good in life because you're white and stuff like that. However, that is not true. You cannot assume the status of a person exclusively by your skin color, by saying that word. I'm sorry, but not all white people are rich. Not all people have to be guilty by slavery, no. By using that word, you're saying that all the white people in Mexico have to feel a certain way. However, they should not feel a certain way. But what do you guys think? Tell me in the comment section down below, and I'll talk to you guys next time.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
He's your
only black friend, so he's your best black friend. I won't trade him for another black friend. Because black friends are rare, as you should be aware. He smiles like Richard Pryor, so just sit and stare. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.